I now move on to leaders' questions, and I call on Deputy Micheál Martin.
Thank you, Cian Corlett. Taoiseach, I'm asking you today to be up front with the Dáil and with the Irish people about a very fundamental issue. I was very surprised last week when it emerged and when it was confirmed that the publication of the comprehensive spending review would now be held back until after the completion of the budgetary and estimates process, and indeed you yourself said the Minister was not going to publish it. In opposition, both Fine Gael and Labour waxed lyrically about an open and transparent process on the budget, and this certainly is not the case here now. And I would like to point out, Taoiseach, that every government department already has supplied the required information as early as last June. Memos were circulated in July. You know what's likely to be proposed. Tell us now, not 1 week after the elections on the 27th and after the voting. And you and your ministers have repeatedly claimed that you've revolutionised strategic planning within government. Well, if you can't even give us dates for when decisions will be taken, how can we seriously believe this? By law, Taoiseach, you must propose spending figures well in advance of the budget, and of course these have to be voted on by the House itself. There are only weeks available now for this to be done. If you won't publish anything, and you won't even say when basic information will be provided, the only implication, Taoiseach, to be drawn is that you're keeping the information hidden until after the 27th of October. And again, this is an issue that's to be added to the list of broken election promises. Taoiseach, essentially the government is delaying the publication of the comprehensive spending review when it notes and when we know that essentially the work has already been completed by July.
Could I have your question?
So you've had the material from the departments for 3 months, you've had detailed reports for 2 months. Why, Taoiseach, the delay in publishing the comprehensive spending review?
Thank you, Deputy.
Taoiseach?
Because it's not completed yet. That's the answer to your question. Look, you wanted to know why the delay in the publication of the comprehensive spending review. The answer to your question is it's not completed yet. Now, believe you me, Deputy Martin, to carry out a detailed analysis of the way expenditure has gone in this country and been allowed to go over very many years is not something that you can do overnight. And the Minister for Public Expenditure and Reform has asked every minister in every department, in every section of every department, to carry out an analysis and report to him in respect of the spending of public monies, of taxpayers' money, which, as you well know, in many instances was absolutely and obscenely wasted. Now, the Minister for Public Expenditure and Reform has not completed his public expenditure review, and the decisions and the information that he has to hand when it's completed, and there's still over 2 months to go to the date of the budget. This process is in train. Obviously, the pre-budget outlook will be available. There'll be the publication of a three-year fiscal plan up front. There'll be the detailed discussions between the Minister for Public Expenditure, the Minister for Finance, and every other minister in respect of what they submit to him. And you'll have plenty of information to digest and discuss in due course. So you asked me a question. What is the delay in the publication of the information about the public expenditure review, a comprehensive expenditure review? It said it's not completed yet.
It was almost completed out of the House.
Yes.
You also said the Minister himself, Minister Howland, said that it would be held back until after the completion of the budgetary and estimates process. Now, let's not try any sleight of hand here. You know what I'm getting at here, Taoiseach. What I'm getting at here, Taoiseach, is you're deliberately delaying the publication of the comprehensive spending review because of the presidential election and its date. The people are facing choices here. The last government published the comprehensive spending reviews well in advance of the budget or any three-year plan. It published it in isolation so that people could see the spending choices that were before them and that there could be a genuine debate on this House about the priorities and the areas that should be protected and so forth, such as special needs assistance, such as education and class sizes and so on. These are the issues that go to the heart of a comprehensive spending review for an informed and comprehensive debate in society and in the Dáil itself.
We're now
and
on
you're
supplementary
actually deliberately, deliberately hiding that information and preventing the publication of that spending review in isolation. You promised and the Minister promised that it would be complete by September. On the record, of this House, and to use your own words,
Deputy,
and I quote you on the 22nd of June, we face many challenges, all of which will
Deputy,
be spelled out clearly as
me.
We unveil the full truth in the context of the comprehensive
spending
review.
Can you ask your supplementary question?
I'm asking the question, basically, why would you not publish that comprehensive spending review in isolation and in advance of the completion of any three-year plan or the budgetary process itself?
Taoiseach.
Your charge is completely invalid. Your own party over the years made many statements. Since I was a child, they were talking about draining the Shannon. I'm not sure what the level of interest that you have yourself in the presidential election. I would have thought that you might have had more interest than... Well, you mentioned that you made a charge here... You made a charge that the information that will emerge from the public expenditure review was being held back pending the presidential election. That's absolute and utter nonsense. As I said to you, the complexity of going through a detailed expenditure review of public monies in every section of every department is not something that you can do overnight. And you're also aware, Deputy Martin, that the government... because of the memorandum of understanding that was signed off on with the state by the previous government, are required to produce a timelined list of complex legislation which has taken up a considerable amount of government time in dealing with. The issue, I go back to your question, and your question was, why are you not publishing the comprehensive expenditure review? The answer is, it's not completed.
Thank you.
I now call on Deputy, would you resume your seat? Deputy, would you sit down and don't be getting no... Taoiseach, just sit down and stop again. Deputy Adams, please.